Mohammed al-Halabi, a United Nations award-winning Palestinian humanitarian worker, has been imprisoned by Israel for nearly 5 years. He faces farcical charges of siphoning money from a humanitarian charity, money which he never had access to, and which, according to the charity itself, and an independent audit by the Australian government, has never gone missing. After 158 court hearings over 5 years, Israel still has not produced one shred of evidence against him, yet it refuses to release him. On the 30th of April 2021, the day of his latest court hearing, Inminds Human Rights Group, along with the Islamic Human Rights Commission, held a guerrilla projection on the headquarters of the BBC in London to highlight Mohammed's plight and demand the BBC stop acting as a shill for Israel and cover his story truthfully. Shamelessly, the BBC has only reported on Mohammed al-Halabi twice in 5 years. Once when he was abducted, and once when another aid worker was abducted. Both times the BBC parroted Israel's lies to give credence to the illegal abductions. The BBC reported at length Israel's charges against Mohammed as truth, but chose not to report when the charity and the Australian government discredited Israel's lies. The BBC also chose not to report when 5 United Nations human rights rapporteurs all condemned Israel's torture and imprisonment of Mohammed al-Halabi. Mohammed's father Khalil al-Halabi sent a short video message for the BBC.
I'm Khalil al-Halabi. I am the father of Mohammed al-Halabi. My son works with children. He is a humanitarian worker, which the United Nations has honored. He has committed no crime. World Vision independent auditors and the Australian government all acknowledge this. Israel knows he is innocent, and yet they have imprisoned him for nearly 5 years. They have taken him to court 158 times. The latest was today, 30th of April. No evidence of any wrongdoing has been presented after so many trials. His 5 children haven't seen him. His youngest son is forgetting what his father looks like. It is the responsibility of journalists. Why has the BBC ignored my son? Why has the BBC ignored my son? They only reported on him when he was first arrested. The BBC repeated Israel's accusation as if they were true, and ignored when the allegations were refuted by the charity and the Australian government. The BBC also ignored when the United Nations condemned his imprisonment. I asked the BBC to live up to its responsibility as a journalist, to speak up about my son. I ask the BBC to live up to its responsibility as journalist to speak up about my son. Only external pressure on Israel will lead to justice for my son.